Welcome to the Cancer Center at Missouri Baptist Medical Center. We are here to provide you with important information that can help you during your cancer treatment. As a patient of one of our three infusion centers, your care team has decided that chemotherapy will be part of your cancer treatment plan. This video will help you understand how chemotherapy works, how it can affect your body, and how to manage any side effects you may experience. You will receive your chemotherapy either through a port or a peripheral IV in your arm. Medications can be given through a port if you have one, and a nurse can also draw blood from your port. If you do not have a port, you will get your labs drawn from your arm in our Cancer Center lab by one of our phlebotomists. When it is time for your treatment, your nurse will place a peripheral IV in your arm. This IV will be removed after each chemotherapy treatment is complete. Now that you understand the different routes to receive chemotherapy, I'd like to discuss how chemotherapy works in the body so you can understand why you may experience possible side effects. Cancer cells can grow quickly. Chemotherapy drugs are developed to kill these fast-growing cancer cells. Because chemotherapy travels throughout the body, it can affect normal, healthy cells that are fast-growing too. It is the damage to these healthy cells that may lead you to experience some side effects. It's also important to know that side effects can vary for every person and may be different for every treatment. Normal cells that are most likely to be affected by chemotherapy include your bone marrow, hair follicles, and cells in the mouth, digestive tract, reproductive system, and nervous system. Let me explain how and why these cells can be affected by chemotherapy. Your bone marrow produces your blood cells. When chemotherapy affects your bone marrow, this can cause low blood counts. When white blood cells, which are our infection fighters, are low, it decreases your body's ability to fight infection. One type of white blood cell, called a neutrophil, is especially important in fighting infections. When you are low on neutrophils, it is called neutropenia. While there's nothing you can do to raise your white blood cells without medication used during some chemotherapy regimens, you can do things to help prevent infection. Wash your hands regularly, especially before you eat and after you use the bathroom. Stay away from people you know are sick and potentially contagious. Because it's critical not to catch an infection, here are some things to remember. Make sure you have a thermometer at home because it is important to check your temperature twice a day. Call your care team for any temperature of 100.5 or greater. With a low white blood cell count, the only sign of an infection may be a fever. If you experience shaking or chills with or without a fever, this may also be a sign of an infection. There are some chemotherapy regimens that require a medication that helps you raise your white blood cells and help in preventing infections. Your care team will let you know if this medication will be part of your chemotherapy regimen. Platelets are blood cells that help stop bleeding by clotting your blood. If your body is low on platelets, you may bleed or bruise more easily than usual. A shortage of platelets is called thrombocytopenia. While there is nothing you can do to increase your platelet count, there are some precautions you can take to protect yourself. Avoid contact sports or any other activities that might cause injury. Use an electric shaver instead of a razor. Use a soft bristle toothbrush to clean your teeth. Do not take over-the-counter medicine without first checking with your doctor. This includes aspirin, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medications such as ibuprofen, Aleve, Advil, or Motrin. These medicines can make bleeding problems worse. Red blood cells carry oxygen to your cells. If you have too few red blood cells, you may have anemia, which can lead to extreme tiredness, dizziness, shortness of breath, weakness, and a racing heart. Your care team will monitor your blood work closely each time you have treatment. If your red blood cell count falls too low, you may need a blood transfusion or special medication to help raise your red blood cell count. Chemotherapy can affect hair follicles, potentially causing hair loss, but not all treatments lead to hair loss. Cells in the mouth can be affected by chemotherapy, leading to mouth sores or white patches inside your mouth, also known as thrush. Good oral care is important in the prevention of mouth sores. Cells in your digestive tract can be affected by chemotherapy, causing symptoms including nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, and constipation. You will be prescribed anti-nausea medications to take after your treatment based on the chemo regimen you are undergoing. During your first day of treatment, your nurse will go over how to take these medications based on your personal treatment plan. Some ways to manage nausea include eating small, frequent meals instead of three large meals. It may also help to eat dry foods without liquid first thing in the morning, like crackers or toast. Avoid fatty, greasy, heavy meals before chemo, but do eat something before treatment. If you vomit, stop eating. Once you stop vomiting, you can start back with clear liquids such as Jell-O, Sprite, broth, and decaffeinated fluids. Then try to take your anti-nausea medicine. You can then try light foods like toast, banana, and rice. If your vomiting persists, please call your care team as soon as possible and watch for signs of dehydration. Diarrhea is another common side effect from chemotherapy because it can sometimes affect the cells that line your intestines. If you develop diarrhea, it is important to stay hydrated and replace the fluid you've lost with clear liquids. You can also try eating bland, low-fiber foods such as bananas, rice, noodles, white bread, and mashed or baked potatoes. You should avoid dairy, alcohol, caffeine, fruits, raw vegetables, or fried foods until the diarrhea has resolved. You may take over-the-counter medications, such as Imodium, to control the diarrhea. If you have had 7 to 8 loose stools in a 24-hour period, or if you are feeling dizzy or lightheaded, you may be experiencing dehydration. Please call your care team so they can determine if you need IV fluids to replace the fluid and nutrients you've lost. Constipation can be a side effect of chemotherapy, but it can also be caused from pain or nausea medications, lack of fluid intake, lack of exercise, or lack of food with fiber. Ways to help avoid constipation can include drinking plenty of fluids, eating foods high in fiber, and doing gentle exercise, like walking. You may also take an over-the-counter stool softener. Before taking any medications, make sure you check with your care team. Chemotherapy can also affect cells in your nervous system. This can cause temporary or permanent damage to the peripheral nerves in our fingers and toes, causing peripheral neuropathy. If you experience any symptoms, let your care team know. They may want to prescribe something to help reduce these symptoms. Your reproductive system can be affected by chemotherapy. Chemo may lower sperm cell or cause short or long-term infertility. Because permanent infertility can occur, it's important to discuss this with your doctor before you start chemo. Men who are getting chemo should use condoms during and right after treatment for 48 hours to protect your partner from exposure to chemo drugs excreted through your semen. Chemo can have harmful effects on the chromosomes of sperm cells. Birth control should be used and pregnancy should be avoided while on treatment. For women, chemo can damage the ovaries and reduce the amount of hormones you produce. As a result, you may experience side effects such as irregular periods or menopausal-like symptoms such as hot flashes or vaginal dryness. Pregnancy in women on treatment is possible during chemo, but should be avoided because some chemo drugs may cause birth defects. It's important to talk to your care team about any questions or concerns you may have about sex and pregnancy while on chemotherapy. It's very important that you take care of yourself during your chemotherapy treatment and let others help you, including your care team, and support from family and friends. A few things you can do include getting rest when you need it, eating well, and drinking plenty of fluids. Fatigue is a very common side effect of chemotherapy. For many patients, this may mean a lack of energy and just feeling a whole body tiredness that is not relieved by sleep. To combat fatigue, it is important to remain active. Daily exercise, balancing rest and work, maintaining a good diet, and expressing any feelings of stress or depression to your care team or support system can help you do this. Eating well during your cancer treatment and recovery is an important part of taking care of yourself. We have dietitians who are available to answer any questions you may have. Make sure you eat enough protein to help your body heal and to keep your muscles strong. Protein is available in animal and plant-based sources. Drink plenty of fluids during your cancer treatment, even if you are not thirsty. It is recommended to drink 8 to 10 cups of clear, non-caffeinated beverages each day. Finally, I'd like to talk to you about chemotherapy safety. During your chemotherapy, you will see that your nurse is very careful when handling chemo drugs. You should know that it usually takes about 48 hours for your body to break down and expel the chemo drugs from your body. This waste is expelled through your bodily fluids, urine, stool, tears, and vomit. If these fluids get on your body, they can harm or irritate your skin and those who are helping you. A few things to keep in mind to protect yourself and your caregiver during this time are to flush the toilet twice after each use with the lid down. Men and women should sit to urinate. Dry your hands with paper towels and throw them away when finished. If possible, use a separate toilet from others during this time frame. Remind caregivers to wear 2 pairs of gloves when cleaning up bodily fluids. Caregivers should wash hands with soap and water, even if they wore gloves and/or if they come in contact with any body fluids. If clothes and sheets have body fluids on them during this time, they should be washed separately in the washing machine, not by hand. We hope this information has been helpful. Always know you can reach out to your care team for any questions, concerns, or difficulty managing side effects. No one fights cancer alone, and your care team is here to help guide you through your treatment.